Hi students, welcome to Plus One Computer class. So you know we are discussing our new chapter Data Types and Operators. In the previous video we discussed about data types, classification of data types. Data types are classified into fundamental data type, derived data type, user defined data type and fundamental data type examples. Okay, integer. For representing integer, we are using the keyword int, then float, double and char. Then one more is there, that is void. And also we discussed about type modifiers. Type modifiers are used to alter the precise precision and range of numbers. Okay, for that purpose we are using type modifiers. So that section is over. What does mean by data types, examples of fundamental data type along with type modifiers. So in this video we are going to start an important topic on our programming, that is variables. Okay, what are the different parts of a variable? Then after that we will discuss about operators. So many operators are present, but we will discuss arithmetic operations, then different types of operators like binary, unary and ternary operator, and after that arithmetic and modulus operator. Okay, so these are the topics that we are going to discuss in this video. So we will start with our first topic, that is variables. Okay, variables. So I think you are familiar with the term variables, because in algorithm, the first characteristics of algorithm is use variable instead of direct values or instead of values. So normally in programming, instead of values, we are using variables. Okay, variables are the identifiers, or variables are also belonging to the category of identifiers. Variables are used to represent memory location. Okay, variables are used to represent memory location. We already studied about identifiers. Identifiers are user defined words. Different types of identifiers are present. First one was variable. Variables are used to represent memory location. Function, header, label also present. What is label? Label is used to represent a statement. Okay, then set of statement, then it is belonging to function name. So at that time I already mentioned variables are very very important. Without variable we can't write a C++ program. So the basic thing of a C++ programming is you want to study how we are using variable, or what are the specialties of variables. So you remember, variable is belonging to identifier category and it is used to represent memory location. You know, computer, when we are inserting anything into the computer, first it will store into computer memory, because RAM provide different RAM, random access memory. Then in RAM provides different cells for storing. Each cell used to, or each cell require 1 byte, or each cell consist of 1 byte of memory. So we already know integer memory or integer data type require 4 byte, float require 4 byte, double 8 byte, character or char 1 byte, then void for representing empty data type. So the type of data, the amount, size of that particular data type, that we already know. So variable is also used for representing the type. Along with the data type you want to represent variable, then only the compiler will identify the size required for storing that particular variable. So before that we will discuss the 3 different parts of a variable. The first part of a variable is variable name. The first part of a variable is variable name. Variable name must be a valid identifier. Variable name must be a valid identifier. Identifier, you know, rules for naming identifier. Okay, identifier starts with letter or underscore. Keywords cannot be treated as identifiers. Uppercase and lowercase character treated in different manner. Then white spaces are not allowed. Okay, so that we already know the rules for naming identifier. Here, variable name must be a valid identifier. Any name we can give, but it must be a valid identifier. Then, next one is, after variable name, next one is L value. Okay, next one or next section for variable is L value. L value indicate memory location of a variable. Memory location of a variable. Memory location of a variable means when we are inserting or when we are storing any of the variable or any kind of data into computer memory, RAM will allocate memory for that particular variable. For example, RAM provides cells. For example, this is a memory cell. Each cell can store 1 byte of memory. So we can write the first memory address is 100,000. Okay, this is a I am assuming 1000. Then the next one will be 1001, 1002, and 1003. So each cell require a memory address. That memory address is known as L value. Memory address is known as L value of a variable. So RAM provide every cell which a unique L value. So when we are storing variable into the computer memory, then L value, according to the L value, we are assigning that particular variable. So L value indicate memory address of that particular variable. Then third content is R value. R value mean content of a variable. What is it? Content of a variable. Whichever value we are assigning to that particular variable is belonging to the category of R value or content of a variable. Okay, what is it? Content of a variable. So I can write like this. So here I am going to declare an integer variable. So I can write like this. Int num. Okay, what is it? Int num. Int means it is a keyword. Int means it is integer variable. So here I am declaring an integer variable. What is that variable name? Num. Okay, what is the variable name? Num. So here I am declaring an integer variable. Its name is num. Then in the computer memory, when we write like this, int num, automatically the compiler will allocate 4 bytes of memory for that variable num. Okay, if the memory address starting with 1000, then compiler will treat 1000 as its address. So we can use 4 different addresses to refer the variable num. 1000, 1001, 1002 and 1003. Any 4 variable or any 4 values we can use to access the variable num. Clear? So these are the 4 values or 4 different values for referring the variable num. Clear? I think it is clear. 1000, 1001, 1002 and 1003. So these 4 values we can use for representing the variable num. Then next one, I am going to assign num is equal to 25. Okay, num equal to 25. Num equal to 25 means here I am assigning value 25 to the variable num. 25 to the variable num. So I can write like this, int num equal to 25. Int num equal to 25. Int num equal to 25 means here we are declaring an integer variable num. Okay, what is the variable name? Num and equal to 25. Here 25 is known as R value of variable num. What is it? R value of variable num. So we can write like this. This value we are storing into variable num. So it will be like this. 2 and 5. So the 4 memory address or 4 L values used for storing 25. So when we write in the num equal to 25, this is happening internally in computer, not externally, internally in computer. So every variable must consist of three different parts. First one is num. Num means it is a variable name. Next one is L value. To refer a variable, we require L value or memory address. So compiler is accessing that particular variable with the help of memory address. Suppose you want to do any kinds of operation in computer, memory address is must. Without memory address, we can't access that particular variable. So, after memory variable name, we require memory address. That memory address is known as L value of a variable. After that, third one is R value. R value or content of a variable. R value or content of a variable that is belonging to the next category. So, in this example, variable name is equal to num. Variable name equal to num and L value is equal to, what is L value? 1000. Then what is the R value? Content 25. So every variable contains these three different parts. Variable name, then variable memory address or L value, then content or R value. Okay, so this is available in your textbook. So you can read your textbook and find out the various points relating to variables. What are the different contents present or what are the different sections of variable? Variable name, memory address and content. Clear? Then, next section is after variables. Next one is operators. Next section is operators. Our chapter name is data types and operator. What is our chapter name? Data types and operator. So the next section was operators. Operators are classified into three categories according to the number of operands. Okay, according to the number of operands, operators are classified into three categories. First one is unary operator. Unary operator. In unary operator, we are using single operand. Okay, what is it? Single operand. Example is unary plus and unary minus. Suppose we want to represent a sign of a number, we can write like this. Minus 2. Minus 2 means it is negative 2. Okay. So, unary plus and unary minus. Plus 12. It is a positive number. So, that's why we are including plus symbol plus 12. Then, every operator or every operation consists of two terms. One is operators. Second one is operands. Operators and operands. Operators means the various operator like mathematical operator, then relational operator like less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. These all are belonging to operator category. Operands means it may be numbers or variables. Okay, operators may be numbers or variables belonging to operands category. So in unary operator, on it is belonging to single operand category. Unary plus and unary minus. And one more is a postfix and prefix. One more is a, what is it? Postfix and prefix. Postfix and prefix. Postfix means A plus plus. A plus plus. It is equal to A plus 1. Then A minus minus. Here A belonging to variable category. So the number allocated to variable A equal to that number minus 1. So example for unary operators are unary plus and unary minus. Unary plus and unary minus is used to give sign for the number. Second one is postfix and prefix. postfix example is A++. Prefix example is postfix A++, plus plus A. Postfix. After prefix is A++. Okay, just opposite. Post means post and also prefix. This is belonging to the unary operator category. Unary operator. Okay, you don't want to study that operator. You want to remember the examples. The first category is unary operator. Unary operator example is unary plus, unary minus, postfix and prefix. Okay, examples for unary operator. Why these operator is known as unary operator? Because it uses single operand. Then, second one, binary operator. Binary operator. Binary operator means the name indicate binary. So, it require two operand and single operator. Example, A plus B. This belonging to binary operator category. A plus B. Then A star C. Again, another binary operator. Because A and B are operands. Then plus is a operator. So it uses two operand and one operator. Clear? Two operands and one operator. So that is belonging to binary operator. Binary operator examples are arithmetic operator, relational operator, logical operator. All these are belonging to binary operator category. For example, A greater than B. A greater than or equal to C. These all are examples for binary operator. So, the second category of operator is binary operator. Then, third one is ternary operator. What is it? Ternary operator. Ternary operator means it requires three operands. Okay, the number of operands is equal to three. That kinds of operators are known as ternary operator. It require three operands. Then example of ternary operator is conditional operator. What is it? Conditional operator. Question mark and colon. Okay, what is it? Question mark and colon. So, this operator is known as conditional operator. That we will discuss in the next chapter. What are the, how we are executing conditional operator. So, you remember conditional operator belonging to which category? Ternary operator category. Question mark and colon. Conditional operator. Question mark and colon. So, according to the number of operands, operators are classified into three categories. Unary, binary and ternary operator. Okay, according to the number of operands. Next, we are going to discuss one more classification of operator. That is, according to the type of operator that we are using. Not based on the number of operand, according to the type of operator that we are using. Okay, different types of operators are present, but in this video we are going to discuss two operations. First one is arithmetic operations or arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators. Example, plus, minus, star, division. These all are belonging to arithmetic operator category. So we can write like this. A plus B. A plus B. Then A minus B. A star B. Then A divided by B. If A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 5. What will be the value of A plus B? 10 plus 5? 15. Then A minus B, 10 minus 5, 5. A star B, 10 star 5 is equal to 15. Then A by B, 10 by 5 is equal to 2. Okay, according to the value present at the variable, we are getting the result. So in computer terminology, this A plus B, A minus B, these all are known as expressions. What is it? Expressions. Instead of equation, we are using the term in programming that is known as expressions. So these all are arithmetic expressions. What is it? Arithmetic expressions. Clear? So these all are known as arithmetic expressions. Then, next one, there is one special operator present in C++. That is known as modulus operator. What is its name? Modulus operator or percentage operator. The symbol that we are using for representing modulus operator is percentage symbol. So modulus operator is also used to find remainder. When we are performing division, if remainder is coming or for extracting remainder, we are using modulus operator. For example, A, B. Here A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 5. A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 5. So we can write A mod B. What will be the answer? 10 mod 5. Is there any remainder? No. 5 is completely divisible in 10. So what will be the answer? 0. There will be no remainder. If we are performing division, then what will be the answer? 2. Okay, 10 divided by 5, what will be the answer? 2. Then, second case. If A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 10. A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 10. And I am going to perform modulus operator. A mod B. Then, I am going to write 5 mod 10. What will be the answer? Here, the first number is smaller than the second number. So, we can't perform or we can't divide number 5 by 10. So, if the division is not possible, then we will get the first number as remainder. So, 10 mod 5, we will get 5 as answer. Clear? 5 mod 10. We can't divide 5 by 10. So, we will get the same number as remainder. Then, next case. Clear? Next case. Here it is 12 and B is equal to 5. So, we can write like this. A mod B. A is equal to 12 and B is equal to 5. 12 mod 5 is equal to what will be the value? 12 mod 5 is equal to 12 mod 5. 12 mod 5, the answer will be 2. Because when we divide 12 by 5, the answer will be 2. But after 10, 2 can't be divisible. So that 2 is coming as remainder. Okay, then another case. A is equal to minus 11 and B is equal to minus 5. A mod B. Minus 11 mod minus 5. What will be the value? Minus 1 as remainder. After 10, next number. Okay? Because the divisible of minus 5 is minus 10. After that, 1 is error. That 1 is known as the remainder. Okay, when we are dividing, now we are getting remainder. That same remainder we will get when we perform modulus operator. Because in programming, in some of the cases, you want to use modulus operator. So that's why, that means you want to find out the remainder and execute according to that. So that's why we require a special operator called modulus operator to find the remainder. Okay, so 11 minus 11 mod minus 5 is equal to 1. That means the remainder we will get. Then, if the number is not divided or we can't divide that number, or if the first number is smaller than the second number, then we will get that same number as remainder. In your textbook, there is one table present. In that table, some examples also present along with the answer. So please find check the answer along with the operations. Okay, so by this we are concluding this video. So we studied about variables in this video. Variables are the identifiers used to represent memory locations. Variable consists of three different sections: variable name, memory address, and content of the variable. Okay, clear? Then next one, L value, R value of a variable. L value means memory address, R value means content of the variable. And after that we discuss operators. According to the number of operands, operators are classified into three category: unary, binary, and ternary. Unary operator example: unary plus, unary minus, prefix and increment and decrement operator. Prefix or postfix, or one more name is the increment or decrement operator. Then next one, binary, arithmetic, relational, all belonging to binary category. Then ternary, conditional operator. Then after that we discussed about arithmetical operator and also modulus operator. Modulus operators are used to find out the remainder of a number. Okay, then you want to write one question in your notebook. What is a variable? Explain the different parts of a variable. There are three different parts of a variable present: L value, R value, and variable name. Okay, so hope you understood. The remaining section we will discuss in the next video.